out. Three sisters of mother who were living with us, and education was not always so easy for them. They all tried to educate us. And your home was called in Holland, in Haben. And we lived in a watchmaker's shop. And by the way, Corrie, you were the first woman licensed watchmaker.
Yes.
I helped my mother, and it was good that I got my license. And I enjoyed the work. And we were a real team, father and I. We were sitting there in the workshop, and we had a very happy life. You know already through the book that we have saved Jewish people in that terrible time that the Nazis intended to kill all the Jewish people. Now, this in Dresden, but I can tell you something that happened in 1844. My grandfather, also a watchmaker, said to his friends, say, come to my house and let us pray for the Jews and for the peace of Jerusalem. And every week they came together to pray for the peace of Jerusalem and the blessing of the Jews. 100 years later, exactly in that same house, grandfather's father, four of his grandchildren and a great-grandson were arrested because he had saved Jewish people. And it was a dangerous work. And often people said to father, if you have always Jews in your house, you once will end up in prison. Father was old. But father said, if I come in prison, I will not stay alive. I'm too old for prison life. Tell me about the house. It was so built that you were able to hide so many in your home. And your home was very old, right?
Yes.
We had a hiding place, but there could be only 8 people. And it was a secret room. And when we were arrested, the people who were in the secret room have not been found. So it was a very blessed secret room. But our life, our work was to bring the Jews to first to other countries, to help them to go to England or to Switzerland. But later that was impossible. And then we placed them in many different homes. But we took care for food, for ration card, and for all the many things that had to be done. And it was a very busy life. But at last, we were betrayed. And that was a terrible time.
And 11 months you spent in prison.
Yes, at last we were betrayed. And we were arrested.
Who betrayed you?
That was a man who had come to me and told me my wife is in danger. She is arrested. She's in a police station. And I'm sure they will kill her. And now I have found a policeman who will run the risk to set her free when we pay him 600 guilds. That's about $200. But I have no money. I should owe him money. What does that matter? Wait a moment. I have 200 guilds. And I asked my friends to give money. And I gave him 600 guilders, and that man was a quisling. You know, a quisling, that was a man who, in secret, helped the Gestapo, but did as if he helped us. And his wife was not all in the prison, but the Gestapo had so told him,